Happy New Year's, everybody. Starting this video off on this cold ass day working on Glenn's truck. If you're like me, you're a dumbass and you load up a bunch of tools to go to the junkyard on New Year's Day and they're closed. So that kind of sucks. There's a bunch of shit I actually really needed to get. But that's fine because I can work on this even though I'm waiting on a couple things. So what I'm working on right now is making a bracket to mount the catch can. So this is going to bolt to that, and then that's going to bolt to the body, and that goes on the catch can, obviously. And I already knocked a hole in the truck right there for the catch can to kind of like sit down through the body, and then that way they can just reach up and drain it and not make a mess in here. So once that's mounted, then I'll go ahead and start pulling the valve covers, and I'll show you what I got to do there. So just got to knock a couple holes in this guy now. So now I got the bracket all made up, the holes punched in it, and got the nutzerts installed in the body, and I put some edge guard on the hole that the catch can will protrude through. So now I just got to install the catch can. Just like that, the catch can's installed. Pretty simple, pretty easy install on that, and looks right at home in there. So now I got to mark where I'm going to put my foot, my vacuum fitting in the intake, and pull the intake off. I already pulled the vangin clamps off, and then pull the valve covers off and start prepping those out for the fittings on those. So that's where that fitting's going to go. This is the bottom of the intake. That's the map. So I pulled the O-ring off so I wouldn't burn it, prepped the area, drilled the hole, and now I'm going to weld that guy on there. And that's a dash 8 because all the fittings on the catch can are dash 8, and all the fittings I'm going to be putting on the valve covers are dash 8 as well. So, yep, going to weld this guy up now. So that thing's welded on there now. I'm going to let it cool down, clean it up, reinstall that, and then pull the valve covers off. That turned out pretty good. Also, if any of you guys watch my videos and you have experience with the Bluetooth pedals for the Lincoln machines, the actual like Lincoln Bluetooth pedal that doesn't have a cord on it, let me know your feedback on that, because I'm thinking about getting one, but I have a couple concerns about like how accurate it is and if there's like a delay or anything like that. So I haven't seen really any reviews on the Lincoln specific one. I know I've seen good reviews for the Miller one, so I'd assume it'd probably be the same for this. But yeah, if any of you guys have first-hand experience with that, let me know in the comments, because I'd really like to see about getting one of those. All right, so I got the valve covers off, got them all prepped. So I'm gonna weld the dash 8 fittings on here and here. This one had the port. The port was back here, so it was like up against the firewall on the driver's side. So I'm actually going to weld that one shut and move the fitting up here so it's symmetrical left to right, and this line won't have to be so long and run like all the way over the valve cover. So now that I got that all done, I'm going to weld the two fittings on, weld that up, smooth that out so you can never tell it was even there, and then the new cap for this thing should be here tomorrow, because it had a press fit style cap. He wanted to go away from that and do another one of these Holley weld-ons that are actually threaded and they have an O-ring on them. So that I overnighted, should be here tomorrow. But yeah, now I'm gonna weld these fittings on. Alright, so got these all welded up. The cap came in today, got it welded on there. Turned out good.
So now what I gotta do is he says that there's a problem when he's putting gas in this thing that like it's just impossible. It just goes click, 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 click. So I'm gonna take a peek at that until he gets here with the another set of valve covers that we could slap on so he could drive it out of here. But yeah, this thing's done. He's gonna make his own lines for it, and hopefully he has good luck in Texas this month. So.
All right, so back at the shop today. I've been working on doing the floors and the firewall and everything for the Speedster, but I had to run some errands this morning. Went and saw my boy Marco and got some new rear tires put on this thing. Got them Kenda KR20s. The old ones were bald as fuck. Hopefully I sell that car soon. I don't know. Someone supposedly is coming to look at it on Sunday. I'll hold my breath. But I'll show you guys what I've gotten done on the Speedster. Worked on it pretty much all day yesterday and got the bead roller all set up and been using the hell out of it. So started making a couple of the pieces that I had. So this is underneath the seats, obviously, so it didn't have to be like crazy or complex. Basically just did that to add some strength to that panel. And then I did this piece, but I realized I fucked it up because there's supposed to be like a triangle shape coming off of it. So that piece is trash. And then ended up doing the firewall too. So it's got a step roll on the edge and then all the patterns are bead rolled in it. And the steering column's gonna poke through somewhere inside of this one, probably like here-ish. But really love the way that firewall turned out. So now I got the front two like footwell compartment panels made. And I got them cut out and laid out for the bead roller anyways. I'll show you guys those. So that's those pieces, and that's the little triangle deal I was talking about. So now that I got those laid out and clean and deburred, I'm going to throw them up on the bead roller and make some sweet patterns and then just toss them in the car. So there's that, got my first section rolled on this. Now I gotta do the same here. When I use this machine or a bead roller, any bead roller, I typically try to do it in stages because it's a lot of strain on everything, really, the bearings, the rollers, the motor. If you just try and apply all the pressure at once, that's why you saw me give it another turn and then make another pass. It kind of sucks having to do multiple passes, but it's better than burning up a piece of equipment. So now the driver's side one's all done. See how it looks in the car. Looks pretty good. The pedal openings are, you know, pretty much perfectly centered, so that's awesome. And I just have to trim a little bit where I had to weld in the floor structure. I'll just have to either trim this or grind those welds down a little bit so this can slide all the way over and hit that the way it's supposed to, but this thing's coming right along, man. It's looking awesome. So, I didn't get too much more done on this yesterday before I left. Basically got both of the footwell areas made and just resting in there. Laid in my template for my tunnel. It's kind of just thrown in there. But really stoked on how this thing came out. I'm pretty much out of material for that, and I'm gonna wait to go buy another 4x8 sheet of 16 gauge to finish it off. And there's also a couple other things I have to do before I weld the floor in on that anyways. So today I kind of had like a free day and the weather is decent. It's overcasty and a little chilly, but you know, it's the best weather we've had all week. So I drove this thing here. And I'm gonna try and make this thing not drive like shit. I'll show you guys some of the new parts So I got my Part Shop Max drop knuckles, which should help a lot. And then some Voodoo 13 USA high offset tension rods. And what else? So right here on the shock tower, this guy is bent. This interlocking tube clamp, I think when I hit Kevin, it tried to like push the wheel in and up. So it basically bent that and bent the firewall where it attaches. So I'm gonna have to fix that, and I'm just looking over the truck. I found a couple other little things that I didn't notice before, like the exhaust, it slipped out of one of the hangers. So I'm gonna have to fix that. There's a couple loose things here and there just from all the vibration. And also, my front tires are in terrible shape. But my size and Zestino's are out of stock right now. But yeah, basically both sides are like that. So I'm gonna put on a less shitty pair of tires, but still probably very shitty. At least ones that aren't showing cords. And these things are flat spotted like hell. So it's just like, feels like I'm driving a fucking dryer with rocks in it. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna start taking all the steering apart and get it ready to put the new parts in. All right, so I got everything off on both sides. Noticed a couple more problems, actually. So my lower ball joints are pretty much shot, and then this control arm was actually loose. So that could contribute to some driving like shit on this. So another thing I'm gonna do is I realized when I did these tension rod mounts and the truck was on the ground, the tension rods were actually pointing down. And ideally, I want them level, so I marked out where I got to drill new holes for this thing. And I'm going to go through both these plates and make raise up the tension rod location on these. And also, I'm going to move it forward a little bit, because with the tension rods maxed out, the most I could get was like almost 7 degrees. I'd like to be a little bit over 7 degrees, so I actually moved the location forward as well, so I'll have a little bit more positive caster adjustment on it. So I'm going to do that right now, and then I'll go ahead and pop these hubs off and put these hubs on these knuckles and go ahead and start reinstalling everything. So, got the first tension rod in, knocked my new holes, and got it lined up, and got it bolted onto the lower control arm. And already it looks a lot flatter, and right now it's drooped too. So, I mean, when it's at ride height, it's going to be pretty much perfect. So, I hope that helps out a lot. And as far as the lower ball joints being bad, I'm gonna end up remaking another set of lower control arms for this thing anyways, so this is just gonna have to wait for now. They're not like super terrible, but they do have some play, so I'll revisit the lower control arm situation at another time. I got a lot to do as it is just today. So yep, I'm gonna go ahead, do the same thing on the other side, get it installed, and then swap the hubs and get the knuckles installed. So another little tip for you guys, if you ever have to do something like this and you're unsure of how to make the two holes line up, what I did was I started with the outside hole. I installed this piece, and it's such a tight fit that it's not gonna, you know, rock in there anyways. And then I have one of these, basically a hole punch, or you know, a center punch, and it's pretty damn close to the same size as the inside of that Heim joint. Slide it in there and give it a whappy whap with a hammer, and then that's all you got to do, and then pull it out and you have a hole, or you know, a center punch there, and then you just run a drill bit through and you'll have it perfectly lined up. Sorry, these are called transfer punches. I was having a brain fart, I couldn't remember the name of it, but yeah, those are called transfer punches. So now I got the knuckles and everything installed. I just got to throw the brakes on, and then figure out how I'm going to fix that shock tower, and then do an alignment, and then the front end should be good. The angle of the tie rods matches the angle of the lower control arm, which is good. And for some reason, this whole assembly, like this whole control arm and knuckle, is further down than that side. It might have had something to do with when I corner balanced it, or I mean, these things keep loosening up on me. Of course, now that I say that one I can't turn, but yeah, these things keep loosening up on me. And the only thing I can think is it's binding up there. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to unbolt it, and I'm going to throw a spacer here to try and bring the top hat to the correct angle to match the coilover. And hopefully that'll fix any binding issue that's causing these, because I've seriously like put a flathead on these and hit them with the fucking hammer to like draw them tight, but it's just like every time I drive it, that's just what happens. So hopefully throwing a spacer up there will fix that problem. Curious to see how well this thing drives now. But yep, I'm going to throw the brakes on now and then move on to fixing the shock tower. All right, so threw a set of wheels on there. It's towed out considerably, but pretty happy with the angle it gets. Since these aren't the right size wheels for the front, the tie rod is actually dragging on the rim, so it'll go even more than that when I get good tires put on those 350Z wheels. So fixed the exhaust. That was it popped out of it. One of the hangers, and show you guys the situation that's going on here. So I think what I'm going to do for now is I'm just going to try and get it back to where it's supposed to be, and I'm going to weld it, and then if I ever have to pull the cab, I'll just sever that weld and it'll come off. And then I don't have a lot of time to mess with this today. I'd really like to do a brace that grabs from here, goes along, welds to the firewall all the way across, and grabs the one on the other side, and then like a plate or some kind of bar that comes up and bolts to that, so everything is tied in along the firewall. But that's going to be like a whole day or two sort of thing that I don't want to get into right now. So just trying to do temporary fixes, at least on that, and the lower control arms, so I can just keep driving it for now, I guess. But yeah, I'm going to straighten this out and clean it up and weld it. So hopefully that holds it. Just beat it back into shape, cleaned it up, and threw a pretty heavy TIG weld on it. So now it's actually flat. So hopefully that holds up until I can make the time to do the firewall brace and all that nonsense. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a break and take this roof off, because now that Kevin has a louver press next door, I want to louver the shit out of the roof, because that's important. And yeah, it's really not important. I just want to do it. So yeah, I'm going to take this roof off and map it out and louver the shit out of it. Make it look like a hot rod. All right, so I got the roof skin off. Now I'm going to take that GoPro mount off probably, and then lay this thing out for all the louvers. And just like that, I have a louvered roof. I was going to do full rows, but then I was like, that's a shitload of work, and I didn't want to do that. So I think this looks pretty cool, having it taper off like that. So now throw it up on the truck and rivet it all back in place. There it is, all final installed on the truck, all cleaned up. I dig it. You guys will have to let me know what you think about it. I think it looks pretty cool from the inside too. So, kind of running out of daylight, so I think I'm just going to line this thing real fast, throw the fender back on it, and then head home and maybe drive this thing back here tomorrow and keep fucking with it, but I don't know. I really don't want to drive this thing at night and come home, you know, when it's late and pissing all my neighbors off with this thing loud as fuck. So yep, I'm going to align it and then probably get the hell out of here. Together, it's aligned, everything seems good from what I can tell. So yeah, I'm gonna head home and I'll probably bring this thing back tomorrow, so hopefully this thing drives good tonight. And then yeah, I'll bring it back tomorrow and maybe I'll try and finish off an exhaust. I'd like to do a bedside exit exhaust on this thing, because there's a project I have coming next week that should take me pretty much all the rest of this month to complete. And then immediately after that, Mike's Cressida is going to be coming in here, and we're going to be going gangbusters on that thing. Cage, paint, we're tubbing the front, doing a bunch of suspension work to it, pulling the motor. So I'm not going to have a lot of time to work on this thing before like any events this year. So, I mean, if, like today, like just one day, I got a lot done on this thing. So hopefully I can bring this thing back tomorrow and mess with it a little bit more. But yeah, I'm gonna head home now. It's getting late. So drove the drift truck home last night. It drives 100 times better. Like, the alignment was still a little off, so I drove it back in today and did just reset the toe on it. Look at the steering angle on this fucking thing. It's pretty impressive over what it had before. I think it's pretty good. It drives so nice now. The bump steer is pretty much gone. Let go of the steering wheel. Before, the front end would kind of like track and try and do weird things. That's pretty much gone now as well. So now that I have the truck here, I reset the toe on it in the front, so that should be good. And now I'm gonna try and build out the rest of my exhaust, and I'll show you guys what I have planned for that. I'd really like for the exhaust to exit somewhere like right there. Maybe down here, I don't know. But I want it to exit in this area, and I have it ending right there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna weld this flex coupler onto here, and then I'm gonna solid mount the back of the exhaust, because typically with exhaust, as you put, you know, engine temps into it and all that stuff, and it gets hot, it'll actually grow up to like a half an inch. I've seen them grow. So if I just weld, you know, it solid to here, and then have it come up and have it rubber isolated, as it gets hot, it's going to actually move back, and then the trim plate that I put on it, it would probably come in contact with it, because I want the tolerances between the trim plate and the exhaust to be pretty tight. So I'm just going to put a flex coupler there and then hard mount the exhaust up here, so then that won't be affected by growth and temperature. So first step with these, I've showed you guys what I do with these before. Because of the multi-layers, it makes it a pain in the ass to weld. So what I do is I just weld them like this right here on the bench, throw a bead all the way around it, and then grind it down, chamfer it, bevel, chamfer the inside as well, and then I weld it onto the exhaust, and then it makes it a much nicer weld zone, welding it onto your stainless tubing. So that's step one. Weld that guy up and then clean it up and get it ready to go on the truck. So I got the edge on both sides all welded up. So now I'll put it on the grinder and face it and bevel it, and then deburr the inside, and then weld it on to the other half of the V-band that's on the truck right now. So got that guy welded on there to the V-band. Pretty decent looking weld. So now I will make this the shape that it needs to be, and weld it onto the other end of there, and then continue on building till I exit the bedside. So pretty much got it all sorted. This is the tip where it exits out the bedside. One of the solid mounts, I need to make one more solid mount, but this one turned out pretty good. I have the back purge going right now, and then I have like six weld mitts to do, and one hanger, and then make the trim piece, and it's good to go. So that's where it's going to exit, and it's actually like pointed kind of down and out, down and back, sort of. So I think it looks pretty cool. So I'm going to weld this up now, and I'll throw it back in there, and do the last two pieces, and that'll be it. Excited to have a full exhaust on this thing. So exhaust is all done now. Got it on there. Got the fill panel on there. I think it looks pretty fucking sweet. I'm excited about it. So I'll show you underneath real quick. So you can see the flex coupler. There's a hanger there, another hanger there, and yeah, the hole in the bedside is 4 inches, so it has a little bit of room to move around and do what it needs to do, but hopefully it doesn't since it's solid mounted. So yeah, fire it up and let you guys hear it. I cheated. I already fired it up and heard it, but yeah, I think that's pretty sweet. That's exactly what this truck needed. It doesn't sound much different than it did, you know, without the exhaust, but now at least it's not going to be recirculating through the rear louvers and making me sick, so there's that. But yeah, I'll let it warm up and I'll give it a few rips for you guys so you guys can hear it better. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. So I'm probably gonna end this video here. Thank you guys for watching, and I got some cool stuff planned for next week and scheduled in for next week. So stick around, subscribe, like this video, and keep watching. Thanks, guys.